Hello, and welcome to the Genre Traveler Podcast. This is your host, Karma Spence, the Genre Traveler. Today, I'm speaking with Joseph Picard. Joseph has just finished a trilogy of science fiction books that deal with nanites, zombie-like things, and cities going to hell in a handbasket. Well, not literally. Welcome to the Genre Traveler Podcast, Joseph.
Thank you very much. Good to be here, figuratively speaking.
The first book's called Life Hack. What's that about?
Our heroine, Regan, she dumps her girlfriend and then moves in with her brother to be a mooch. And she picks a bad city because the city, shortly after she moves there, dead things start walking around. And they don't know at the time, immediately, that it's nanite-based. And she eventually finds this out and finds allies and falls in love with a lady who really doesn't want her affections, being that she's straight. And that's really inconvenient. That's the major subplot, and that's Regan's biggest problem, other than the dead things running around and her brother being dead. Like the number two book, there's no zombies in it. Zero.
And that's Watching Ute.
Yeah.
So tell us about Watching Ute.
It's the world after Life Hack. Hey, I have to rewind a little bit. That technically, I kind of cringe when I call it a trilogy because it's not the same characters running through. There's some supporting characters that go through all three, but overall, the protagonist is different. The location of my imaginary country is different, and it's kind of a differently thematically themed, I guess. There's a different vibe. I tell people I've got a continent just to the east of South America, and they figure, oh, it's like an Atlantis thing. It rose out of the ground. No, it's always been there. And I wrote this little thing, it's never been published, I probably should, about its role in World War II, for example, and how it was a semi-important place to refuel, basically. It wasn't tactically important, but it was a landmass that was convenient for some people. The fact that it's been there the whole time is something that, you know,
it's an alternate Earth.
No, it's our Earth. It's just, there's this continent that nobody's never really bothered with. The tagline I came up with after the fact, like about a month ago, which I wish I'd put on the back of the book now, but too late.
Second edition.
I guess so. The tagline I thought for Splash to get the attention is, Sarah's got daddy problems, daddy issues. Her daddy built her out of fish parts, lives in her head, and killed millions of people. But he's really, really sorry. Honest. Which kind of sums up the setup for the book altogether, because Erebus, who doesn't like to use that name anymore because it's associated with all those millions of killings, decides that he wants to put something back into the world, something that's good, so he creates himself a daughter. And in order to do this, not having a body anymore, not a human body, he has to build her in using similar technologies that he did to manipulate zombies, but he didn't want to use any parts of anybody living, because that would be wrong, so he understands. So he finds a bunch of dead fish. He hangs out in the ocean and waits to find a dead fish. He won't kill them either, because he thought that would be wrong too. So he found all these dead fish and a seagull, which he was very proud of, and he didn't kill any of them, and he built his daughter out of these parts on a molecular basis. She looks human, and for quite a while she thought she was human, and he sets her out into the world to go live a normal life, which, when you're made out of fish and made of banned technology, turns out to be a little more difficult than you would think.